Return with Rimboy. Return with Rimboy. Oh, return.
Guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Wimbod and you're watching Real Time with Wimbod. On today's episode, we'll be talking about plastics. The reason why I chose the topic plastics is because I see plastics around, and plastic pollution has become a thing in our society. It is something that everybody is dealing with. Plastics do not easily decompose, and we are finding alternatives to use other than using plastics, a way to make sure that our environment is safe. Now, the main reason is that the government did come out in 2019 to say that they will not be banning plastics, and the reason being pharmaceutical companies use plastics and all that. But the main thing is, pharmaceutical companies do use plastics, yes, we agree, but the plastics that they use are not plastics that affect our everyday lives. They are not plastics that block our drainages, you know, like the plastic that actually causes the problem, that causes the menaces in our society, are the ones that we use every day, like the polythene bags, the takeaway bowls, the water bottles and so on. These are the things that actually causes the problem. Now, I did a little research into plastic pollution, and I would be telling you what it is and the effects and all that, so stay tuned. The benefit of those who do not know what plastic really is, plastic pollution is the accumulation of anything plastic, rubber bags, takeaway bowls, bottles, these things that adversely affect wildlife and our environment as a whole. So as of 2018, 380 million tons of plastics were produced worldwide. And as of that 2018, 1 million tons of plastic was generated from Ghana. So to put things in perspective for you to understand what we are talking about, averagely a 40-foot container weighs 4 tons. So above is a picture of what a 40-foot container looks like. So we'll need about 250,000 40-foot containers to be able to get 1 million tons of waste. To begin with, let's talk about the solution. What is the proposed solution? What I am proposing. Now, I think that the water producing companies should turn to things that can decompose, can easily decompose or be bent. Things like paper. With water, they can produce it in paper containers, let's say, like instead of a bottled water, we can have like paper water, like the ones we have where the milk companies have, and the ones that those juice companies are using. We can actually tend to that, though it will might be a little expensive, but what is money compared to life, you know? So we can also, for the food vendors, let's go back to our roots. We can go back to using the leaves that we used to eat from. The water vendors still use leaves. Most of them still use leaves, but they have come to, they've now adopted a way of wrapping with rubber. But why don't we just stop using the plastic and continue to use the leaves that we were used to, leaves that we were, our forefathers were using? That could help. So like I was saying, the water companies and those who sell products and services could go back to using paper. It wouldn't be a permanent solution, since they'll be cutting trees to produce them and all that. At least they decompose, but for now we could start by using paper, and then later we find a better solution, or we could find a more sustainable solution to this. Not necessarily for a long term thing, because we are looking for solutions that wouldn't be creating issues in the near future. We are looking for solutions that are sustainable. And for the meantime, we can't be using paper bags for now until we get a better solution or a better alternative to plastics. So the next time you're buying food from that water seller, and the next time you're buying bottled water, please do remember that we are trying to save our environment, and we are trying to protect ourselves, and we are trying to stay healthy. So stick to paper if you can, and please advise others to stick to paper if you can. So see you in the next video. Thank you for watching. Bye.